Bloodstock 2013, we're here with the second-rate Angels, straight out of Hemel Hempstead, and winners of the Reading Metal to the Masses. Please introduce yourselves and what you play.
Hello, I'm Andy and I play the drums.
I'm Dave, I'm sing and play bass.
You couldn't remember what you did there, did
you? Yeah, I'm Chris, I play guitar.
Matt, guitar.
So, you're playing later on the stage, on the New Blood stage. Yeah. What can people expect from your, what is your sound?
Our sound is just, well, fast, it's metal, but really melodic with double guitar solos and a lot of singing. I don't do too much screaming, to be honest.
Lots of catchy leads, you know, lots of catchy hooks, and it's powerful metal, really. Powerful, melodic, catchy
loads
stuff.
Masses of energy.
Any influences?
Oh man, we're so influenced by so many different things.
Yeah, every band, old school, you know, bands like Metallica start every fucking one with metal, don't they? But just everyone ever after them, you know, Killswitch Engage, one of my favourite bands at the minute, new albums, Wicked, saw them last week in the garage in the hottest gig ever. Just anyone, there's so many great bands here today, like Lamb of God, they're drumming, you know, on Saturday it's going to be absolutely brutal. Yeah, just Bloodstock, man, it's fucking metal through and through, isn't it?
So what does it mean to the band then to be playing, to have won Metal to the Masses and to be playing here at Bloodstock?
It's quite exciting, we're pretty pleased.
I'm pretty damn stoked, yeah. We can't believe we're here.
It could be worse.
It's very surreal at the moment.
We could be playing the pub down the road, you know, saying, yeah.
It's
fucking awesome we're here. Like, we worked so hard last year. We came in so close, second place. It was like our 12th show we'd ever done together. This year, we fucking worked our asses off. We've done a UK tour this year. We've been gigging the fuck whenever we can. And we finally got it. We wanted to play in the field this year. We're standing in the field. We're happy, man.
So you entered it last year as well?
Yeah, we were in the London one last year. We got to the finals of that and we came second.
Our 12th gig we played together.
Fantastic, but it just goes to show, though. Kept gigging, did a UK tour, practicing, came back and won it the next year.
Yeah, so just worked hard as we could and trying to make our trade better, so.
We spoke to Simon last year, we said, what can we do to improve? What did it go wrong? He told us, tighten these sections up, do this, you know, just really, you know, and we'll come back this year and we'll just
have more experience playing and just keep at it. That's what we've done, you know, and we've just come back a lot stronger, you know, this year in the competition, and well, we're amazed to have won it, but we've, you know, we've worked hard and now we just want to go out there and play. You know, the waiting game has been going on for too long and we're just itching to get up there.
I suppose what this offers for young bands as well is, you know, because young bands continue playing at small gigs, small pubs, but this gives a focus, this gives a reason to put in the extra 20% in the rehearsal room.
It really does, but it's taught us a lot, you know, playing in the several heats, you know, to get to the final, playing with some really great bands and meeting some really great people, you know, and we've just learned so much in doing that. I'd say, you know, to every band out there, upcoming band that, you know, wants to get to a festival like this, get involved with Metal to the Masses, try and get to one in, you know, the nearest region to you. And,
it's probably the best thing that's happened to Unsigned Metal, really. Yeah. It's the only opportunity you have of being seen by a lot of people, and not just people, but industry people as well. As an unsigned band, it can be quite a depressing thing, especially on tour, when you're just no money, no food, travel lodge.
And it's quite hard to get out of one circuit, isn't it? When you're an unsigned band, you get certain venues or certain promoters will put you on, and you don't get seen by the rest of the country. Whereas here, in that stage, later on, there'll be people who are just there. I know loads of people who are just here to see the stuff on the New Blood, because that's what they find really exciting. So
brilliant. It's just brilliant. It really is. It's a fantastic opportunity for us, really. I can't wait. I'm really excited.
There are so many great bands, like you say, so many great new bands, you know, to check out, and we'll be checking out, you know, plenty of them for the rest of the weekend, you know. As soon as we've done our show, that's it. We'll be out there mixing with the others, you know, checking out the shows, crowd surfing.
Excellent. Well, guys and gals of Bloodstock World, make sure you do go and check out Second Rate Angels.
3 hours to go! Ah!